अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू लेक्चर टू। होप यू हैव स्टडीड द लेक्चर वन। इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल डिस्कस सम कंसेप्चुअल क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन, रिजेंबलेंस ऑफ न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन विद न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन, ग्रेविटेशनल फील्ड एंड ग्रेविटेशनल फील्ड स्ट्रेंथ। फर्स्ट कंसेप्चुअल क्वेश्चन इज, Do you attract the earth or earth attracts you? Which one is attracting with the large force? Or why the object falls toward the earth if earth and object attracts each other with the same force? Its answer is yes. According to Newton's law of gravitation, we and earth attract each other with the same force. But question is, then why the object falls toward the earth if earth and object attract each other with the same force? The answer of this question is based on the Newton's second law of motion, which states that acceleration of the object is inversely proportional to the mass of the object. This relation shows that if the mass of object is more, then the acceleration will be lesser. Since as the mass of earth is very large as compared to the mass of the objects, so acceleration of the earth will be very less as compared to the acceleration of the objects. That's why small objects accelerate more than that the earth. Now question 3, what will be the effect of force of gravitation between two objects when the distance between their centers is reduced to half and masses remains same? Consider we have two objects of mass m1 and mass m2, and the distance between these two objects is d. Then according to Newton's law of gravitation, the force of gravitation F will be equal to capital G multiplied by m1 multiplied by m2 upon square of the d. Now as the distance is reduced to half in question condition, then we will take d is equal to d by 2. Due to change of this distance, this gravitational force will also change, that it becomes F prime, and d will replace with d by 2. In the next step, we will open this square bracket and it will be d square upon 4. In the next step, we will remove this division sign and convert it into multiplication sign. If this division sign is removed, then the second fraction is flipped over, then we will get F prime is equal to 4 multiplied by G M1 M2 upon D square. If you will see this value capital G M1 M2 upon D square, it is the value of this force. So we will replace it with F. This relation shows that the force of gravitation between the objects is increased 4 times when the distance between their center is reduced to half. Now question 4. How does the force of gravitation between two objects changes when the mass of one object is doubled but the distance between them remains same? It is the force of gravitation between the mass m1 and mass 2 which are placed at a distance d. According to question condition, if the mass of one object is doubled, so we will take m1 is equal to 2m1. Due to change of this masses, the gravitational force between the object will also change, let it become F prime, m1 replaced with 2m1. In the next step, we will take 2 as a common, so we will get F prime is equal to 2 multiplied by capital G multiplied by m1 m2 upon d square. It is the value of the force F, so we will substitute here F. Now this relation shows that the force of gravitation between two objects is doubled when the mass of one object is doubled. This question number 5 is similar to the question number 3 and 4. try to solve it. In this topic, we will discuss the resemblance of Newton's law of gravitation and Newton's third law of motion. Consider we have two objects of mass m1 and mass m2. According to Newton's law of gravitation, m1 attracts m2 with the force F, and m2 also attracts m1 with a force of same magnitude but in opposite direction. Consider the force which is on m1 as action and the force which is on m2 as a reaction. Then this action and reaction are equal in magnitude but opposite in a direction. Now if you will see the Newton's third law of motion, it states that every action has its reaction which are equal in magnitude but opposite in a direction. It means that Newton's law of gravitation is consistent with the Newton's third law of motion. Now we will discuss gravitational field. It is the space or region around our body where the gravitational force exerted by one object can be experienced by the other object is known as gravitational field. If the object is out of the gravitational field, then the gravitational force cannot be felt. What is gravitational field of the Earth? Let's discuss it with this diagram. It is the Earth, and as we know that Earth attracts every other object towards its center with a force. This force is called force of gravitation of the Earth. If the object is near the surface of Earth, then the gravitational force which is exerted by the Earth on the object will be stronger. But if the object moves away from the Earth, the gravitational force becomes weak. It means that when the objects go further and further away from the Earth, the gravitational force becomes weaker and weaker. And at some region, the mass will not felt the gravitational force. So we can define the gravitational force of the Earth as it is the region or space within which the gravitational force can be felt or experienced by the object is called gravitational field of the Earth. Now these are some characteristics of the gravitational field of the Earth. One is gravitational field exists all around the Earth. Its direction is toward the center of the Earth, and gravitational field becomes weaker and weaker as we go further and further away from the Earth. What is gravitational field strength? In the gravitational field of Earth, the gravitational force per unit mass is called gravitational field strength of the Earth. It is the formula for the gravitational field strength. Eg is equal to Fg upon m. Eg is the gravitational field strength, Fg is the force of gravitation of the Earth, and m is the mass of the object. If we will substitute the SI unit of these quantities, SI unit of the force is Newton, SI unit of the mass is kilogram, then we will get SI unit of the gravitational field strength, which is Newton per kilogram. It is a vector quantity. Its direction is in the direction of the force of gravitation. Its value at any place, its value will be numerically equal to the value of g at that point. For example, on the surface of Earth, the value of the g is 10 ms - 2. So the gravitational field strength will be 10 newton per kilogram on the surface of Earth.